When we talk about quantitative usability testing, we usually recommend that you include a fairly large number of users, around 40, to make sure that the numbers obtained from your study generalize well to the whole user population. When you include just a few participants in a study, it's possible that their individual circumstances and backgrounds skew the results in one direction or another. Now, almost inevitably, when our conference attendees hear that, they start questioning another one of our recommendations: to test with only 5 users in qualitative user tests. After all, if you test with only 5 users, it means that your findings will not generalize to the whole population, doesn't it? This question is so frequent that we need to address the misunderstanding. The reason for different sample size recommendations in qualitative versus quantitative studies stems from their different goals. In quantitative usability studies, the goal is to measure the usability of a system by estimating how your general population will fare on measures such as task success, errors, satisfaction, and task time. If we include just a few participants in the study, the resulting numbers will be unreliable and not capture the behavior of the general population. In contrast, qualitative user studies are not trying to capture the behavior of the whole population. Rather, they just aim to detect usability issues with the design, so these could be fixed and the team could move on to a new, better version. The new version will usually also get tested and improved on. Qualitative studies do not try to predict how many users will complete a task, nor do they attempt to figure out how many people will run into any specific usability issue. And while there is a statistical uncertainty about any number obtained from a quantitative study, there is absolutely no uncertainty in a qualitative study. Any error identified is a legit problem that someone encountered and needs to be fixed. In the early 90s, Jacob Nielsen and Tom Landauer built a mathematical model that shows that by doing a qualitative test with 5 participants, you will identify 85% of the issues in an interface. And NNG has repeatedly argued, and justly so, that a good investment is to start with 5 people, find your 85% of the issues, fix them, then test again with another 5 people, and so on. It's not worth trying to find all the issues in one test, because you'll spend too much time and money, and then you'll be sure to introduce other issues in the redesign. To recap, when you're collecting numbers, you should include larger sample sizes in your study in order to make sure that your numbers capture the behavior of the whole population. After all, if you only look at 2 to 5 users, what's the chance that their average time on task will be close to the average of your general population? But if you're simply trying to collect usability issues, even watching 5 users will give you plenty of real issues to work on.